Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video we are going to see what is electrically equivalent circuit of crystal oscillator and the graph of reactance versus frequency. So let's begin with the topic. We know that crystal oscillator is basically a material which exhibits a property of piezoelectric effect. Quartz crystal is a material which is most commonly used for construction of crystal oscillator. So whenever the AC input signal is applied across a quartz crystal material, it starts producing mechanical vibrations at the output. The frequency of output vibration is similar to the applied AC input signal. Whereas if the mechanical vibrations is applied across a quartz crystal, then it produces AC signal at the output. And the frequency of AC signal is now similar to the applied vibrations. The frequency at which the maximum vibrations that can be produced by the crystal oscillator is called as resonant frequency. Now let's see how the electrical equivalent circuit of crystal oscillator looks like. Basically, the crystal oscillator is nothing but the tuned circuit, and it uses piezoelectric for resonant tank circuit. So let's see the electrical equivalent circuit. So the electrical equivalent circuit basically consists of RLC1 connected in series with each other, and then it forms a tuned circuit which is connected parallelly with the capacitor C2. So when AC input voltage is applied across crystal, and if the crystal is not vibrating, then the circuit is somehow similar or equivalent to capacitor C2. But when the AC input signal is applied and the crystal starts vibrating, then it is similar to RLC1 tuned circuit. Now, the second figure shows that a graph between reactance and frequency. So, the crystal oscillator having two resonant frequency, that is series resonant frequency and parallel resonant frequency, that is FS and FP. Now, let's see what is actually FS and FP is. So, the first frequency is called as series resonant frequency. That is nothing but FS, and in this case the value of L is now equal to value of C1. That means the value of reactance of inductor is equal to value of reactance of capacitor, and therefore the value of series resonant frequency FS is given by the formula FS is equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L C equivalent. Now the other frequency is nothing but parallel resonant frequency. Now in case of parallel resonant frequency, the reactance of RLC1 branch is now equal to reactance of C2. Therefore, the parallel resonant frequency is given by formula FP is equals to 1 upon 2 pi square root of L C equivalent. And C equivalent is given by the formula C1 C2 divided by C1 plus C2. Usually the value of C2 is very much higher as compared to C1, so we can consider it is approximately C1, and FS is equals to FP at equilibrium. That means the series resonant frequency is approximately equal to parallel resonant frequency. So this is what about the electrical equivalent circuit of crystal oscillator, which consists of one branch having a series connection of RLC1, which is connected parallelly with the other branch, which consists of only capacitor. When no AC signal, when no vibrations, then circuit is similar to C2, and when AC signal is applied and the circuit starts vibrating, then it is similar to RLC1. Now another term that is important related to crystal oscillator is nothing but Q factor and frequency stability. The Q factor, that means the quality factor of the crystal oscillator, is very much higher as compared to tank circuit, and therefore it is used in most of the application like digital circuit, it is used in the communication transceiver and digital watches. The frequency stability of any circuit is get changes with respect to time. This change in the frequency is called as frequency drift. So the drift occurs because of the many parameters, which includes temperature variation, aging of component, environmental effect, and many more. So in case of crystal oscillator, the frequency drift value is very much smaller, and therefore the crystal oscillator circuits are most commonly used circuit in time-based circuits. The crystal oscillator can be used to provide frequency range from 15 kHz to 10 MHz. But if we increase the frequency beyond 10 MHz, then no signal will be produced at the output. As the crystal oscillator having very less value of frequency drift, therefore they are mostly used circuit in the application where frequency stability and accuracy of the output is important. So this is what about the Q factor, which is very high in case of crystal oscillator, and frequency stability, which is very low in case of crystal oscillator. So I hope you understand the electrical equivalent circuit of the crystal oscillator, series resonant frequency, parallel resonant frequency, Q factor and frequency stability of the crystal oscillator. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.